Good evening, and thank you very much for joining me again today. Muchas gracias por acompañarme una vez más el día de hoy. I had such a great experience last time that I wanted to repeat those moments and feelings. And even more, so after receiving many emails, phone calls, and notes, requesting me to continue with these presentations from my home to your home. On June 25th, I introduced to you the music of my latest CD, Bridges, from Chopin to Piazzolla. And today, it is an honor for me to present the music of the famous Argentinian composer Astor Piazzolla. Piazzolla, trained as a classical musician, had a dream. It was to transfer the tango from the dance floor and bring it to the concert stage. When he was 40 years old, his parents, Italian immigrants to Argentina, brought him to New York, where 40 years later, he learned how to play the bandoneon and the piano. And was here also in New York City, where Piazzolla, many years after, he had a very successful performance in a Central Park with a very large audience. The video we are going to watch today is a live performance recorded at the Argentinian Consulate of New York City. The video 2 years ago where I honored is a live music of Piazzolla in the mouthpiece at the Argentinian Consulate of New York. But that night I also made a very special announcement. It was the first time that I publicly announced the idea of a new CD, which now is my latest CD, Bridges. And I explained the connections between five composers through five generations, starting with Chopin and ending with Piazzolla. It was an unbroken chain relationship, mentor, student, through five generations in 100 years. That's why in this performance, I played in the middle a piece by Gina Stera, Piazzolla's teacher, and at the end, I performed a nocturne by Chopin to show how the circle musically closes between Chopin and Piazzolla. The performance is 1 hour long and I perform 8 pieces by Piazzolla. El Mundo de los Dos, Our World, Imperial, Imperial, Adios Nonino, Goodbye Dad, Ciao Paris, Goodbye Paris, Invierno Porteño, Verano Porteño, Milonga del Ángel, Milonga of the Angel, and at the end, the last piece, Liber Tango. During the performance, I explain each piece, the history of each piece, and the meaning. I will be watching with you this performance, and at the end, I will be here with you to share my thoughts and to say goodbye. Es un placer para mí presentar la música de Astor Piazzolla. Después de mi última presentación con tanto suceso, recibiendo emails, notas, llamadas telefónicas pidiéndome que continuara con estos conciertos, he decidido hoy, en el mes del aniversario de Piazzolla, presentar sus obras. Voy a presentar un video que fue grabado en el Consulado Argentino de Nueva York, en donde además al final del concierto expliqué la idea de mi nuevo CD, que ahora es mi último CD, y por eso en el medio del concierto toqué una obra de Ginastera, el maestro de Piazzolla, y al final toqué un nocturno de Chopin para demostrar cómo el círculo entre los dos compositores, Chopin y Piazzolla, la música de ellos se cierra. El video dura una hora, toco 8 piezas de Piazzolla, El Mundo de los Dos, Imperial, Invierno Porteño, Verano Porteño, Adiós Nonino, Chau París, Milonga del Ángel y Libertango. Los voy a esperar, voy a estar mirando el video con ustedes y al final los quiero saludar, decir unas palabras de mis pensamientos. Así que nos vemos en un rato.
Tonight, we are celebrating the music of the famous Argentinian composer Astor Piazzolla. This year is the 25th anniversary of his passing, and also in March is the month of his birthday. And me, as a woman and as an artist in the month of the women, I'm proud to perform the music of Astor Piazzolla, whose dream was that his music will be more recognized after his death. But when he was alive, he wasn't recognized enough. Piazzolla, for most of the Argentinian people know, Piazzolla was very famous because he transformed the piano, the tango, the traditional tango, into a classical tango, a new tango. And he incorporated the rhythms and the, from jazz and classical music. He was a classical musician. And also, the other big contribution of Piazzolla was that he took the tango from the dance floor and he transported to the stage, to the concert halls. Now the music of Piazzolla is performed in the best halls in the world for the best artists, not exclusively pianists, no? He was a bandoneonist. I'm going to start with a piece called a tango, slow tango called El Mundo de los Dos, Our World. I did the world premiere of this tango at Carnegie Hall in 2011, and the world premiere recording in my CD Esperanza in 2009, when I decided to dedicate my performances and my recordings to the classical Latin American composers since 2009. The first tango, Our World. the story about this tango, the music of this tango was given to me after my performance at Lincoln Center by the poet who wrote the lyrics of this tango. It was inspiring, a true story, a love story that Piazzolla had in the summertime. And after that experience, he asked Albino Gómez, the poet, to write the lyrics for this tango. Now my next tango is called Imperial. Also I did the world premiere at Carnegie Hall and in the CD, Esperanza. And this tango was inspired, Piazzolla was inspired in the palaces, was impressed about the palaces in France when he went for a scholarship from the Argentinian government, and he went to study with Nadia Boulanger. And he was to study composition, classical composition, that it was his field in that time, even if he was on the side playing the tangos. Imperial. Piazzolla, when he went to France to study with Nadia Boulanger, she said to him, "I saw you on the side playing this music, this kind of tango. This is what you have to do if you want to success in your life. You are wonderful in classical compositions like this, but you have to follow." My next tango is Invierno Porteño. Piazzolla wrote The Four Seasons, and this particular tango, Invierno Porteño, is very melancholic, and is completely different than all the other tangos. It expresses more the feelings of the people in Argentina. And I explain to you more after performing. I want to explain Argentinian comes from means port, and Buenos Aires is a port, and then that's why they have so many immigrants. 80% of the population in Argentina are Italian. And then, not everybody who lives in Argentina is called porteño, but the person who lives in Buenos Aires is called porteño. That's why he wrote this Verano, Invierno Porteño, Verano Porteño. And now, I'm going to play Verano Porteño, which means summer in Buenos Aires.
Thank you.
I promise you to talk a little bit more about Piazzolla's music, more for the people who are here in the audience and not from Argentina. One of the other teachers who encouraged him to write about the tangos, it was the famous Argentinian composer Alberto Ginastera. Piazzolla studied with Ginastera when he came back from Paris. Piazzolla was living in New York for 15 years in Greenwich. And his father saw that he was playing the bandoneon all the time. He gave the bandoneon to him. And Piazzolla, as a teenager, was playing this bandoneon in the Latin American reunions. And then when he was 15, they came back to Argentina. Then he got a scholarship. And he studied with Ginastera. Ginastera told him, Astor, follow your feelings, you have to write more this beautiful music, which is not the tango, the regular tango, the traditional tango. And he had so much passion for this music that he had his own band and chamber music. And he was playing with this band in the halls at night until 4 a.m. in the morning. And at 7 a.m. in the morning, he went to rehearse with the Philharmonic Orchestra in Buenos Aires. And then I'm going to explain that I decided to perform one piece by Ginastera, and then maybe perhaps you can hear some of the connections between the lyrics that this piece has with the phrases in Piazzolla. This piece is called Wit, the Wit Dance, and it's from the ballet Estancia, which means French. And describes the whole day in a ranch where the workers are cultivating the wheat and how you see all the lights through the leaves. The whole the wheat dance. Thank you. tango is called Adios Nonino. You know, Piazzolla was in a tour when he found out that his father died. And he came back to Buenos Aires and he wrote this tango. And it's called Adios Nonino because his family, his parents, or his family were from Italy. And in Italian, Nonino is grandfather. And he called Nonino to his father. And then you can hear in the first measures of this tango that the melody is not so sad. And then when I was learning the tango, I was searching what those measures mean for Piazzolla. And then I found out that he wrote in his earlier years another tango when his father was alive. And then he took these measures and represents in this piece the happy moments he had with his father, who was actually who encouraged him so much to pursue his dream.
Thank you.
means goodbye Paris. He wrote this tango when he decided to come back to Argentina. He was in Paris studying with Nadia Boulanger, and he decided that he wanted to come back. And it has a mix of melancholy and happiness at the same time, mix of feelings. And he wrote this tango when he was walking aside the river, the Siena River, like saying goodbye to Paris.
Thank you.
Now, my next tango is actually is called Milonga of the Angel. This tango, Piazzolla wrote a series of the angels. And he believed that in this particular Milonga of the Angel, he believed that at Christmas time, there is an angel who comes to Argentina to heal the soul of the people. Because you know that the Argentinian people, we are 80% or even more from Europe, from immigrants. Then they used to gather in the cafes in Buenos Aires, those immigrants, to share the feelings of melancholy and nostalgia, and at the same time, hope and passion, because they moved to another country with hope. And then that's why, as explained before, the tango was born in these cafes. And Piazzolla took these feelings, and in this particular Milonga the Angel, he believes in this particular angel who comes just at Christmas time. And in the other series of the angels, has another connections with the same feelings. And then something I like to tell you, I don't want to forget, is that when Piazzolla dreamed in having his music in the concert stage, when all of this happened, started in Argentina in the cafes, the tango was more for dancing. But then he said, I want people to sit in a hall and listen to the tango, enjoy as a concert, like tonight. I'm going to play Milonga of the Angel.
Thank you. Thank you.
Williams.
His teacher, Williams studied with the best disciple of Chopin. Then when you listen to this music, actually, it comes from the romanticism. And my next CD, Ironic Records, asked me is to record all the generations, Chopin, Williams, Ginastera, and Piazzolla. When they came to my last concert at Carnegie Hall, the president of Ironic Records said, Rosa, I don't know why when I hear Piazzolla, I hear Chopin. He said, why don't we record the CD, just Chopin and Piazzolla? And then I was searching and realized that it was a surprise. I can play in all tune by Chopin. Coming to the beginning.
Thank you so much for sharing with me this special concert. I hope you enjoyed Piazzolla's marvelous music as much as I did when I played it. It was an unforgettable and magical night to be, as it is today to be together with all of you. I will see you soon and have a great night. Muchas gracias por compartir este concierto tan especial conmigo. Espero que hayan disfrutado la música maravillosa de Piazzolla como yo estoy disfrutando la compañía con todos ustedes. Los veré muy pronto y espero que tengan muy buenas noches.